Hey, everybody. Welcome back to the 702 Rock Show. Hey, if you like what you're listening to, don't forget to like us on Facebook, follow us on Twitter. We're also on Vine, Instagram, Foursquare, and you can read about it in every issue of My Vegas Magazine. And we're on 702 Rocks at YouTube. So I'm here with the fabulous Sarah Jane Woodall as my co-host and the amazing Jessica Talamantes and photographer Billy Ward. We're here, talking about the fun things that are going on here in Vegas, and when it's hot and the pool season is in gear, well, these are the hot people that you need to know. So, Sarah Jane Woodall, you've been modeling for a while. You do amazing photo shoots. You're a great model, and it's a lot of fun, all the different dynamic modeling that you do. Doesn't matter if it's out in the woods, and you're hugging a tree, or you're out at motorsports or motor speedway, and you're like around chicks that you feel like are like not models, and you're like, what am I doing with these girls? Yeah. You know, I love your honesty, your posts, your blogs, all your pictures, everything.
Some might call it cattiness.
Honesty.
Mm.
Love it.
It's a fine line.
Confidence.
Mm. And one of the well-known photographers that you've worked with is Billy Ward.
Billy Ward is one of my favorites, and we have him right here in the studio.
Hello.
Yay. Billy. Billy, we love you, and we appreciate your work so much.
Yes, we do.
Thank you. I love you, too.
So, Billy, I wanted to bring you here because you've worked with Sarah Jane, and you guys did a Victorian shoot that was one of my faves. It was...
Oh, the Marie Antoinette.
Yeah,
the cake whore.
God, that was so beautiful. Tell us about that and the setup and how much time it took. And, I mean, because you don't just have models come over and you just shoot them. I mean, you got to put up the lights. You got to set up everything, get the right lenses and everything. Tell me about it.
Sarah had contacted me about doing a shoot with Tara Lee, and
yeah, we have to give a shout out to Tara Lee, the Empress.
Yeah,
she brought us all together.
Yeah, she brought it together, and we went over to her place and shot it, and that's actually coming out in Man Cave.
Sweet.
Magazine next
nice.
Month. Yeah,
so
got a writer doing a story, a funny story up on Marie Antoinette, and
so basically just a brief description of the shoot for people who haven't seen the pictures is three chicks all dressed like Marie Antoinette with fancy frilly lace everywhere and these cakes, and we're just like snorting lines of frosting and shoving cake in each other's faces. That's why we call it cake whores.
It was awesome.
It's a pun. Coke whores, cake whores.
But it was beautiful. Like, it was light pinks and light blues and white lace and ivory. And where'd you find all the props?
Tara had it.
Did
Tara
she?
Has it. Yeah.
She's had it set up, and that's her living room right there?
Yeah.
Really?
Just went over there. And
wow.
That's cool.
That's amazing.
Knocked out that shoot.
Now, as a photographer, you were telling me, we're talking about being professional, and, you know, you have to be a little selective when it comes to models that you work with, because some of the models don't exactly take modeling seriously, so therefore you can't get paid if you are not having someone, well, that's going to work with you, right?
Yeah, I have models that are trying to build their portfolio or whatnot, so I do my job and, you know, try and make it, give them the best photos I can or bring the best out in them so that they can do and whatever they want to, you know, move on and progress.
So Sarah, what aspects of a model did Billy help bring out to, you know, bring out your portfolio?
Well, like I said earlier, he just knows his lighting, and lighting is so crucial to a good photo because it can make or break you. It can show every line on your face, or it can make you look like a dewy, fresh-faced young ingenue, which is Billy's style.
Nice. You actually said that you're going to be shooting some fitness models coming up soon.
Yes, I got, I'm shooting a fitness model in a couple weeks here, and I have some fitness models coming down from Canada in July. There's a competition going on, so, yep.
That's
I'm going to go in that direction.
And where do you find these models? I mean, fitness models and tattoo models, and where do you find all of them?
networking,
yeah,
or they find me somehow, you know, social media, they...
Everybody wants to shoot with Billy.
Yeah.
He doesn't have
to
find anybody. They come to him.
Pretty much.
Yeah, okay.
They're beating down his door. Trust me, I know.
So tell me, did you have to go the different locations that you shot with Billy? I know that you did it at your friend's house.
We did the one thing at Tara's house. We shot out in front of Las Vegas High School once, the old, that really cool Art Deco high school downtown. We did this awesome picture where I'm a little schoolgirl and I'm holding a notebook in one hand and a stripper shoe in the other, like, which way should I go?
Right.
And it's
yeah.
a great shot because it says Las Vegas High School right in the background. Like, it's perfect. So that was on location.
That's awesome.
We shot at my house.
Yeah.
In fact, can I talk about a really amazing shoot I did with him?
Absolutely.
With this amazing
yeah.
product?
Oh, sure. Yeah, yeah.
Yeah. So Billy was hired by this guy who invented the most amazing pussy in a shoe.
What?
Can I say that? It's like a stripper shoe with a pussy in the bottom of it.
Can
for
she
guys?
Say that, Irma? Yeah? Okay, she can say that.
It's for guys who have a foot fetish. So
they have a foot. Oh,
I'm not kidding. This guy had the prototype, so we shot it at my house. Man, I mean, it's. I think this guy's gonna make so much money because, you know, there's a lot of cam girls, webcam models.
Well, isn't the popular right? thing like the pussy in the soda can thing that you unscrew the top?
It's similar,
and it's,
but it's in the. You know how those
like a flashlight or something?
Yeah, it's a flashlight in the sole of a big
go.
Platform shoe.
That's
yeah,
cool.
Yeah.
So,
yeah.
anyways, back to the store. He invented this great.
Yeah, and he hired Billy to shoot it. And what's going on with that guy?
I haven't heard from him in a while. The last time I spoke with him, he said that someone was trying to pick it up. So
I bet they were.
Yeah.
Someone was trying to
pick it up. And you push your big toe, remember you push your big toe and it vibrates.
Really?
Oh, that's yeah, right. Yeah. It has like little controls on yep. the foot pad.
Oh my
that's
God.
So cool.
It is cool.
I need one of those shoes. I hope that they have it in a size 9.
Maybe one of your fans will send it to you.
I wonder if they
I know. I need to put it on my wish list.
Yeah.
I wonder if they made
for
like
sure.
a Nike shoe and that replica and just said, just do it.
Good.
Yeah. Yeah. Or maybe like a maybe like a Reebok shoe, you pump it up. Yeah.
Oh,
pump it up.
So many applications.
Gosh.
The guy's got to come out with the whole line.
What are you going to do, huh?
Yeah, they should have different colors and like different sizes.
There you go. Light up and vibrate and
yeah.
pick your color and your style. And
so one with the landing strip.
So, Billy, what is your yeah. favorite part about being a photographer?
Meeting a lot of people.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Now, I know that you've shot for like Hustler and what other companies locally have you shot for?
I've been shooting for some local restaurants and bars and models and, you know, several magazines. Yeah, that's I just do whoever starts contacting me, I try and, you know.
See, this is what I like about Billy. He doesn't toot his own horn. I know so many photographers that are like, oh, I'm the greatest. I do this. I do that. Like,
nice.
Like I said, he's technically probably one of the most proficient photographers I've ever shot with, but he doesn't brag about it. He's very humble.
And one thing we were talking about perverts is that you have never slept with any of the people that you've shot before.
No.
Is that do shoes count?
You're blushing.
Yeah.
I know. I was like, I put him on the spot.
Right.
Put him on the spot. No, I'm serious. There's a lot of photographers out there that will hire you and say, I'm a big time photographer. I'm professional. Now, can you take that off and can you do this? And, you know, and then Sarah, you'd be like, yeah, okay, no.
Right.
Right? A little too far. There's a lot of perverts out there.
There
you got to pick, you have to be selective when you find a photographer.
Yeah, I keep it professional.
There you go.
Yeah.
Because even on a porn set, you don't sleep with the photographer. It's the male talent, and the photographer doesn't even touch you.
I know. So. I could just imagine, Jessica, you're on set, you're being filmed, and then you get hit on by the photographer. Hey, I like your look.
Well, I mean, I've
you
only
got
shot
some
for
beautiful
Score
eyes.
And Pumper Pass, so they're really professional. They're a photographer. Plus, the photographer for Score, he's gay, so
that
he
makes
wouldn't
it
have not any interest in me. But they're always respectful. Like, if you shoot for a professional company, yeah.
So, Billy, give out your .coms, social media sites.
www.billywardphotography.com. And you can also find me on Facebook. / Billy Ward Photography and Instagram Billy_Ward or Twitter at BillyWard1.
And Billy did make my Zed card and I love it. He is awesome to work with. He's shot my dogs actually, and one of the fashion companies turned into a t-shirt, which was hilarious. I wanted to do a little Christmas card and all of my dogs ended up on t-shirts. So Billy is an awesome photographer. Do you have a phone number in case?
Yeah. Yes, 702-217-0590.
Awesome. Well, when we get back, we are going to bring on Matt Donnelly. He is an actor. He is also from Matt and Mattingly.com. So stick around. It's right here. It's on the 702 Rock Show. Hey, everybody. Welcome back to the 702 Rock Show. I'm Michelle Roxy Davis. And if you like what you hear, follow us on Facebook, like us on Twitter. We're also on Vine and Foursquare and Instagram and LinkedIn. And you can watch us on YouTube. Read about it in My Vegas Magazine. So here's my co-host, the beautiful Sarah Jane Woodall and the gorgeous Jessica Talamantes. They are here to, you know, boost up the show, sexy ladies, especially Sarah Jane. She's in her bikini, be it that you can see it, right? Everyone's on radio.
I know, but I'm feeling just a little inadequate.
Are you?
Oh, geez.
Oh, well, you're next to an H and fun. A double D, so.
It's not all that. I know, and I'm a double A. What's wrong with this situation?
You know what? Yeah, honestly, I think a C cup is the best.
So, like, if you could just sort of average us all out, it'd be good.
Matt, what do you think?
I would. That's exactly what I have, is I have a C cup, so.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Who's at the table? Congratulations.
I'm actually, in all of my shows, I'm rarely that I don't have the biggest tits in the room, but today is a little different. It's a little weird for me.
Matt Donnelly, he's an actor. he is with Matt and Mattingly.com. He's also with Penn Sunday School. So he is a podcast machine.
Yeah. Between the two, I put out three a week.
That's crazy.
One with Penn and then two more with Paul.
Yeah. So tell me about the ice cream social.
Well, Penn Sunday School gets a lot of listeners, mm-hmm. and I have a lot of fun on there. Penn doesn't have a lot of time because, you know, he's a famous entertainer.
He has twins, doesn't he?
He has two children, but they're not twins. But he's got two twins.
Busy guy.
He's always on television shows and doing magic, you know, 5 nights a week at the Rio.
Lots of stuff.
He's a busy guy. So I thought, I don't have those jobs, so I should maybe start another podcast. And
there
so we kind of did like a spinoff of Penn Sunday School just to have two more episodes a week for people who like listen to podcasts.
So how'd you come up with the name Ice Cream Social?
Penn just blurted it out.
Yeah.
And when he does that stuff, I just tend to listen and write it down. He's a smart guy. He's a very successful entertainer.
That's true.
And the Sunday School theme kind of has this quasi, you know, religious community type of feel to it. And Ice Cream Social does as well. It also sounds less intense than Sunday School, which is accurate
That's
to the
true.
Podcast because Paul and I are pretty much just comedians. We happen to be godless, but we are just mostly comedians
godless.
First.
I was listening to one of your shows today, The Sex Worker and Juggalo.
Oh, yeah.
With Kim
Fabel.
Yeah.
Kim Fabel, a very funny lady.
Now, she is the manager at Deja Vu.
Yep.
And she was talking about all the different toys that they sell, and they were even talking about a penis for a penis.
Yeah. That was one where I was
listening.
I rarely think about like who's listening to my podcast. I tend to not care about language.
You don't want to talk about
or
that?
Topics. No, I'll just say that like what's funny is that very topic was the first one that I was like, I think my dad listens to this show.
You're like,
but
yeah.
We were discussing docking.
So
the
there were different
of the docking.
You were talking about different toys and
yes.
just kind of you guys talk dirty about all sorts of stuff.
Well, that's it. Is that like it's tough because Paul and I don't consider ourselves dirty comedians, but we don't care if it does become dirty.
You just say funny things and you don't care if you mix in a lot of adjectives and stuff.
We could tell knock-knock jokes to kids for hours.
Right.
We could also talk about docking for hours.
There you
That's
go.
Just the way we roll.
So I know that you were talking about lime bird nest water.
Oh, man. Yeah, I guess in Japan, they are some kind of... They try to sell it with some holistic property, but they literally make a drink from bird nests, like old bird nests.
The poop
and
everything.
Somehow, yeah. Just the wood, the twigs, the all of it, and they make it into this distilled water drink that supposedly...
What is it supposed to do?
I don't know. Boost your memory, your sexuality, or... Your open psychic powers. I mean, no matter what, whatever the thing is, that can't be the number one way to get it.
I don't get
it. Like, we can't have missed everything with vitamins and fruits and vegetables. We can't have missed all of it, and all of a sudden, bird nest water was the one thing that we needed
diet
to turn it all around for us.
Oh, gosh.
But, I guess it's a popular drink in Japan. Not popular. Popular is a strong word for it.
I don't get it.
I guess they make it in Japan.
They had a fantasy where you lick eyeballs in Japan, and now it's bird nest water. Like,
oh, man.
Where do they get this?
Anytime
a nuclear fallout, maybe.
I don't get it.
I don't like to stereotype. I really don't like to stereotype.
Right.
But anytime someone says like, "Oh man, have you seen?" and they describe some really twisted porn, it's usually starring at least one Asian.
And I'm glad that you said porn because you were mentioning a very good point that Jessica, before the internet came out, it was porno.
Yeah.
The internet made it porn.
That's my whole thing.
I saw the light up in your eyes. Like,
yeah.
Yes.
Yeah, that's my big point. Where I was listening to a comedian. And he was like, and my son, I caught him looking at porno, and I was like, ah, that joke's old.
Yeah.
I was like, that joke that you're telling, super old, because no one calls it porno anymore.
Right.
What made porn from when the internet created from porno? What, the O was just
nobody
gone?
Nobody has time for that extra letter anymore.
Yeah.
We don't have time for the O. LOL. Nobody got time for that.
We don't have time for the music. We don't have time for the setups.
Don't have time for scripts, plot.
Ain't nobody got time for that.
It's gonzo all the way.
Right.
Too many syllables.
Too many.
I used to have a half hour of porn time to listen to the music and the setups and the plots. Now I got 3 minutes. I don't even have time to say O.
But now the big bushes are back. What do you know?
Yeah.
The O's are gone. The big bushes are back.
Is that true? Is that like vintage is back?
Have you not noticed that everyone is trying to dress like hippie-ish / Woodstocky?
You know who warned people about that?
What?
Cameron Diaz.
Really? Mm-hmm.
Cameron Diaz warned ladies saying, watch doing the permanent hair removal downstairs, because you never know.
That's true.
Where fashion
Cameron
is
Diaz
going.
Cameron Diaz and Gwyneth Paltrow, they're both big Bush supporters.
Yeah.
And I kind of like that, because the older you get, the crazier hair grows in areas that you don't want them to. And I look down and I'm like, are you serious? It was 3 days ago. Up to my belly button? I can't believe this. What are you going to do? What are you going to do? I guess I'm latest
in
the
fad. That's why monokinis are in style.
Monokini.
That thing up the middle hides that nature trail.
I guess I don't need a bikini anymore.
I never thought about that's what the monokini is for. That makes a lot of sense.
Right?
Do they make those in a Spanx version for people like me? Do they have like a monokini that like tightens it in?
Yeah, but have you heard about vajazzling and panazzling?
I have heard of that.
Have you ever thought about having a big bush vajazzle party? That would be fun.
Wow.
You could mix in some ice cream socially.
I just want to read the invitations. I just want to send those out.
How would that be? You open the card and it's a big poof with rhinestones all over
like,
it.
Yeah, it should be like an explosion of confetti. A little that and perfume. It should be confetti and perfume. The jazzle
what
party.
What do you think? What do you think, Sarah Jane?
I'm thinking cornrows might do well.
Cornrows? That would be cool.
Like a Bo Derek 10 kind of thing.
Little beads hanging at the bottom. That'd be cute.
Cornrows, I'm going to think of Predator more than Bo Derek. I should make a mental note to think of Bo Derek first.
Yeah, please.
I'd probably get out like my hair straightener and, you know,
get the hair dye.
Get the glitter out. Lots of fun stuff.
I've only heard of it conceptually and seen it in photos. I've never been a witness or a practitioner of bedazzling private parts.
It would be interesting, especially if you had a group of ladies that were just standing around waiting in line to get their vajazzling on, and they're just kind of sitting there around talking about bushes and
just tweeting stuff. Still waiting for my vajazzle.
God, when is my bird nest water going to get here?
Jeez. Right, or taking a selfie while I'm getting vajazzled.
I know.
I was on the set, and we had the slowest vajazzler. The day took forever.
Gosh. And then I'm thinking, you know, with your bush all vajazzled, do you go to a party? Do you go to a pool party and show it off or something?
You have to show it off.
What do you do?
Go to one of those nudist colonies.
Oh, gosh. I mean, I need to know these things.
Green
but
door. Oh, it would be worse if you came home and you're like, you're getting changed into your comfy clothes and you're like, oh, shoot, I forgot to show off my vajazzle tonight.
Gosh.
I spent all night talking and drinking and telling stories. I should have been mentioning my vagina to show it.
I can just see, women passed out everywhere with their shiny vajazzles, and they wake up and they're just screwed, and they're like, literally.
I gotta tell you, I'm for it. I don't think it's silly. I can imagine being a wonderful surprise if I were to somehow get to the part where I gain trust, get invited back to a lady's place.
You undress the panties and all of a sudden, poof, it's shining in your face.
That just is really, that would make me a very happy person. Honestly, it really would. It would make me feel like this person was thinking about it and they didn't tell me and they really wanted to like mess with me.
Like the pot of gold at the end of the rainbow.
Well,
she took the words right out of my mouth.
I know that Angie McComb from Classic Tans does panazzling, so I was going to invite her to have that for you if you'd like.
I'm Irish. I would need like two rhinestones tops.
There you go.
I would need like...
Well, we're going to take a commercial break when we get back. We're going to talk more fun stuff right here. Stick around on the 702 Rock Show.
Hey, this is Las Vegas Larry the Cable Guy. I'm here at the Gene Woods Racing Experience with the Rock Vault on the 702 Rock Show.
We're back. Are you ready to rock? Well, here's your 702 Rocks host, Roxy.
Welcome back, everyone, to the 702 Rock Show. Hey, if you liked what you're listening to, don't forget to like us on Facebook. We're also on Twitter, on Foursquare, Instagram, and LinkedIn at 702 Rocks. The show archives every Monday at 9 p.m., and you can also check it out at 702rocks.com and read about it in every issue of My Vegas magazine. I am also on YouTube at 702rocks. So, back to my lovely guest, Sarah Jane Woodall. What are you going to be doing this weekend?
I'm going to Florida
tomorrow. Wait, let me touch your button. There we go.
I'm going to Florida tomorrow.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
Nice. Mm-hmm. What are you going
to
do there?
I'm making an instructional video, like a cooking demo on how to make canna butter.
That's cool.
Yeah.
Sweet.
So look for that coming soon on my YouTube channel.
There you go. And what's your dog?